count by tens, starting with 40. Fill in the blanks. So let's count by 10, starting with 4, or count by tens, starting with 40. So 40 is 4 tens. So if we add 10 to that, we're going to get 5 tens, or 50. Now if we add 10 to that, we're going to get 6 tens, or 60. Now if we add 10 to that, we're going to get 7 tens, or 70. But we don't have to type that in because they've already put that there for us. But then let's keep adding tens. So if we add 10 to 70, or 10 to 7 tens, we're going to have 8 tens, or 80. Add 10 to that, you're going to have 9 tens, or 90. And then we're done. Let's do one more of these. Count by tens, starting with 656. Fill in the blanks. Well, each time we want to add 110. So this 656, it's 6 hundreds, 5 tens, and 6 ones. Well, now we're going to add 10 to it. So instead of having 5 tens, we want to have 6 tens. So it's going to be 666, 6 hundreds, 6 tens, and 6 ones. Let's add 10 again. Well now, in the last one we had 6 tens, now we want to have 7 tens. So it's going to be 676. Now let's add another 10. Well now we're going to have 6 hundreds, 8 tens, and 6. Or 686. Now let's add 10 again. So now we're going to have 6 hundreds. Instead of 8 tens, we're going to have 9 tens and 6 ones. So 696. Now the next one's going to be interesting. We want to add another 10 to this. But how do we have, if we add another 10 to this, what do we have in the tens place? Well, one way to think about this is, you could view 6 hundreds and 9 tens as 69 tens. So if you have 69 tens and you add one more 10, you're going to have 70 tens. So you're going to have 70 tens and 6 ones. So 696, you add 10 to it, you get 706. Once again, you could view this as 65 tens and 6 ones. So 65 tens, 66 tens, 67 tens, 68 tens, 69 tens, and 70 tens, 706.